We're going to determine the following four limits using the provided graph. First, we have the limit as x approaches 1 of f of x. Well, here's where x equals 1. And notice as we approach positive 1 from the right side, our positive side, we're approaching a function value of positive 1. And as we approach positive 1 from the left side or negative side, we're also approaching a function value of positive 1. And therefore this limit equals 1. Next, we have the limit as x approaches positive 2 of f of the quantity x plus 1. So notice as x approaches positive 2, the input into the function approaches positive 3. And therefore on our graph, because the input is approaching positive 3, we'd be approaching this vertical line from both the right side and the left side. So notice as we approach an input of positive 3 from the right side or positive side, we're approaching a function value of positive 2. And as we approach an input of positive 3 from the left side or negative side, again, we're approaching a function value or a y value of positive 2. Therefore, the limit is equal to positive 2. Next, we have the limit as x approaches 3 of f of the quantity 2x minus 4. Well, notice as x approaches positive 3, the input would be approaching 2 times 3 minus 4, or 6 minus 4, or positive 2. So as the input of the function approaches positive 2, we're actually approaching this vertical line here from both the right and the left. So as we approach from the right or the positive side, notice how the function value is approaching negative 1. And as we approach from the left to the negative side, again, the function value is also approaching negative 1. And therefore, this limit is equal to negative 1. And now for our last example, we do need to be careful because we do have absolute value here around f of the quantity 4 plus x. Notice as x approaches 0, the function input would be approaching 4. So in this case, we're approaching this vertical line from both the right and the left. And for this example, let's write out both one-sided limits. So now as x approaches 0 from the positive side, or as the input approaches 4 from the positive side, we'd be approaching in this direction here. Notice how the function value is approaching negative 1. But we do have the absolute value of this function value. Therefore, this would be equal to the absolute value of negative 1, which would be positive 1. And now as we approach 0 from the negative side or left side, the input would be approaching positive 4 from the left side. So we're approaching from this direction here. And notice how the function value or y value is approaching positive 1. So this would be equal to the absolute value of positive 1, which is positive 1. So because these one-sided limits are the same, this limit does exist and is also equal to positive 1. Notice how if we did not have the absolute value here, these two limits would not be the same, and therefore the limit would not exist. But because of the absolute value here, the limit does exist, and it's equal to positive 1. I hope you found this helpful.